A new functional class for us is the carboxylic acids. They have a C double bond O, OH functional group. Here I've shown all the bonds in that group, and oftentimes we start abbreviating the structure a little bit. Here I've left out the bond between the O and the H. Sometimes we leave out several bonds, CO2H or COOH, are acceptable ways too of showing the carboxylic acid functional group. Carboxylic acids drop the E of the longest chain, the base word, and add oic acid. So here in this example, we'd still follow all the rules for nomenclature. We'd want to find the longest chain that includes the functional group. It'll become our base word and so forth. I see a chain of four, so the base word would be derived from butane. Drop the E, add oic acid, we get butanoic acid. And the carboxylic acid group is like the aldehyde. It'll always be on the end of the chain. It'll always be at position number one. And so I didn't put in one butanoic acid because it's assumed that it's at position one. But it establishes the numbering system for us. One, two, three, four. At position three, we have a methyl group. The complete name then is 3-methyl butanoic acid. Let's look at an aromatic acid. When you have a benzene ring with a carboxylic acid group attached, it's called benzoic acid. And it's a common name, but it was used so commonly they accepted it into the IUPAC system. So then we have a substituted benzoic acid. This ring position would always be number one. That means that we've got a group attached at position two. It's a 3-carbon group, so it's propyl, and it's at position two, so it's 2-propyl benzoic acid. And again, the groups that we'd like you to know are 1, 2, and 3 carbon groups, methyl ethyl, propyl, and isopropyl. In this section on carboxylic acids, one of the reactions that they undergo is with base to form salts. They can react with sodium hydroxide to form sodium salts, or potassium hydroxide or calcium hydroxide, anything that's a base. And when they react, they form an ionic compound. It's just like sodium chloride in a sense. We've got the presence of ions, and we name them like an ionic compound then. Back in inorganic chemistry, two words. The first word is the name of the metal, sodium in this case. Then the second word is all the rest of the structure. And it's going to be the name of the carboxylic acid, but we change the ending. Rather than oic acid, it's oate, O-A-T-E. So our carboxylic acid that we named a second ago was 3-methyl butanoic acid. This portion now becomes 3-methyl butanoate, sodium 3-methyl butanoate. Let's look at the esters. The third naming skill that we'd like you to have in this section would to be able to name the esters. Carboxylic acids react with alcohols to form C double bond O, OR kinds of functional groups, and these are called esters. We name them in two words, a little bit like the salts, or very much like the salts, I guess I should say, because esters too are going to end in O-A-T-E. The first word is the name of this group over here, whatever it is, methyl, ethyl, propyl, or isopropyl. In this case, we have a 3-carbon group attached at the end carbon. It's a propyl group. Now we're concerned about naming the carboxylic acid portion. It's a 2-carbon carboxylic acid. So the name would be derived from ethanoic acid. We change the oic to O-A-T-E. Let's look at this structure. This is similar to the carboxylic acid we named a minute ago, but the group over here has changed. It's a benzene ring, and when benzene is used as a group, it becomes phenyl. So phenyl is the first word. then the name for the carboxylic acid, but the ending changes to OATE, phenyl 3-methyl butanoate